Everybody, it is Saturday and I got some batteries, so I'm able to make a decent video today, not an ugly desktop video that I cannot stand. So okay, let me tell you about today. Okay, so this morning, before I get into this morning, I want to say thank you to the very lovely Peridot, who left me a very nice comment on yesterday's vlog, where she pointed out for all the world to see how awful my hair and my skin are. Thanks, Peridot. Thank you, friend, for saying, yeah, your skin looks bad and your hair. So, no, I know you meant it like out of concern, and so, I know, sweetheart, I know. I am out of vitamins, I am out of a lot of stuff, and I haven't been eating anything of substance, and so I need to start doing that again. So hopefully when I get some more money, I'm gonna just rack up on stuff for like the hair and the skin and the nails and then, you know, everything that I'm out of. So yeah, so no worries, mate. What else? Okay, so I get up, right? Or rather, I was woken up this morning because the cats didn't have any more food. They're out of food and they're out of litter. Ugh. And my kid also was hungry. So I forget that people eat and animals eat, even though I don't. So, my husband got home late last night, exhausted and sick, kind of still. So I tell him, listen, I need a couple of bucks, or take me to the dollar store and I can just buy the cat food and stuff right now. The cats won't leave me alone. The cats will continue. They woke me up by nibbling on my face and my nose and my toes and my legs. And every time they do that, I get a little preview of what it would be like if I died in this apartment and later I was stumble upon because the disgusting corpse smell that came out of here. And so I imagine that the cats would be doing the same thing, kind of living off of me. But I think that I would be kind of tough, like beef jerky or I don't know, like a freeze-dried piece of fruit or something. So but yeah, they were hungry, so my husband gets up and he gives me a $20 bill. So I'm like, wow, you really are sick still. I'm like, let me check for it. And so I go to the bathroom. I wake up. As soon as I get out of bed, I have a massive headache. And my God, I'm trying to figure out why. It felt like I was hungover, even though I got some sleep. And then I think it was because last night I was talking to my sweetie pie on the computer, the boy, and I was eating sunflower seeds. Not a lot, but just like a couple of them. And so I think that's what happens. I think that all that salt and stuff probably gave me a headache or something. So I get up, I go to the bathroom, and of course I weigh. My weight didn't go up, thank God, and I was just staring at my body, and I noticed after I got out of the shower, because I had to take a shower to see if it alleviated this headache, that like I could see the first two bones of my rib cage on my chest, and it's not very attractive. So yeah, I need to start eating a little more. So I go to the dollar store, I get in my car, I take my Wellbutrin. I don't take the anxiety pill yet because I want to hold out for a little bit. I want to let the anxiety kind of start happening and then take it, not take it before. Let me see if I can kind of settle myself down or find a way to cope with it, because my fear lately has been that I take the pill, you know, I don't have an anxiety, I take the second one, the anxiety's gone, and then the anxiety comes, like a big attack, and then I'm without medication, and what do I do? You know, I need to find a way to cope and stuff, because the other night I couldn't sleep because of something similar. So I decided not to take it. I didn't have anxiety yet, but I did feel like awful because I still have the headache. My vision is kind of blurry. I have cotton mouth, and I feel like, I don't know, I feel like kind of lightheaded. So, but I was able to drive. I had to the Family Dollar, and I go ahead and get, you know, cat food, cat litter, especially cat litter, my God. I decided to get some batteries so I can make a decent video today. And I got some puzzles. So I got this one. This one's 504 pieces. And this one's going to be a very nice contribution to the migraines, because there's thousands of pieces that look alike thanks to the sky and the ground. But it's very nice. I love puzzles. And I plan to finish that. So I decided to get one for me and my child. And this is Cinderella. This is 204 pieces. Oh, 200 pieces, my bad. And, you know, she's excited to do this one. I love Cinderella. Cinderella is my favorite Disney character, my favorite princess. I love her for obvious reasons. The poor girl slaves away her whole life and has no friends except the freaking rodents. And and finally someone comes and sweeps her off her feet and saves her and takes her to go live far, far away in a nicer land or whatever. So, one can only hope. So, yeah, I decided to get that for me and my kid to do later. In the parking lot of the dollar store, I feel nauseous, like really nauseous. And the only thing I have in my stomach is the Wellbutrin. And one spoonful of peanut butter that I took in the morning just to have something in my stomach. So, I'm trying my best to not throw up, and kind of just because I don't want to throw up the pill. So, I get home and I can't take it anymore. I mean, I had to. I felt like really the anxiety was starting. I was feeling like dizzy. I was feeling really nauseous. I had like freaking cold sweat on my forehead. So, I threw up the freaking peanut butter and the pill. Oh my God, I purged the pill. So, not good. So I decided to take the pill again, because I purged the pill and the pill wasn't even digested. Like, I have awful digestion. The only thing that was gone from the pill was like the writing, and that was it. I'm like, wow. So I decided to take the Wellbutrin again, and this time take the anxiety pill and the little bit of vitamins that I have in stock in the bathroom. So hopefully they will digest. I'm not feeling nauseous now. I'm drinking a little bit of ginger ale, kind of counteract it. So I'm hoping it stays down there. So yeah, the kitties are fed. My kid is fed. My husband left for work a little while ago. He had to go in early. He gets out early today. He says he's feeling better. He wants to eat. So I'm going to make some barbecue chicken and like some mashed potatoes from scratch and mac and cheese or something. So, I mean, yeah, it's good he gets out early or whatever for him. It's not good for me because the boy gets out early. He's at work right now and he gets out early. And so I wanted to camp with him tonight, so I can't. Whatever. So, what else? I was talking to the boy last night, and he was sending me this link for this townhouse that was up for rent. It was a two-bedroom, two-bathroom, near where he lives, and it was really nice. And he's like, look, it's almost perfect. And I'm like, what are you talking about, almost perfect? And then I read the thing and it says no pets allowed. And so yeah, but his mom is allergic to animals. She's one of those people, like, she can't be around any animal. So, and he's an animal lover, and they had a dog once and they had to give it away, and it's kind of sad. So So he really wants like a pet. Like he likes that I have my cuckoo cats. Like when I camp with him, the cats are everywhere, and he's just like kitty kitty, and so he likes my cats. But I told him that my kid wants a dog, and so he's like, oh yeah, we gotta get a dog, we gotta get a puppy. And so we like the same kind of dogs, you know. We like either the very big extreme kinds, like the German Shepherd that I used to have, or like the little fluffy dogs, like Pomeranians and Maltese and like Shih Tzus. We don't like Chihuahuas. We don't like those little bitchy yappy dogs with like the hard head, and you hold them up and they're all stiff and stuff. No, we don't like those kind of dogs. So, but yeah, and plus like fish and all that shit. We agreed we were gonna be animal hoarders together, and when we live together. So, he's like, damn, it was almost perfect. So, but he kept sending me links to like apartments and stuff. So, he got out really late last night, like at midnight from work. He was really exhausted, so I stayed up an hour with him, and then we both went to bed at the same time. He was feeling kind of lonely last night, and so I was just trying to snap him out of it. I actually asked him, like, what does he do on days that he feels really lonely? Because, you know, there are days that I feel like that a lot of the time, and I really don't know, like, what to do, you know. It's a lot you have to do to kind of keep yourself busy and not think about that, or let it consume you and get to you and stuff. So I was just curious, like, how does he deal with it, you know? And he was just telling me that he watches a lot of anime, or he like finds something to do, and that lately the thing that he's been doing, it's just been, he's like, just think about us being together, think about us living together, just do, think about that, you know. He's like, I do that lately, and it's, you know, like gets me through and stuff. So I thought that was kind of sweet. But yeah, I was joking with him about, because he's asking me how my job search was going. So he was joking with me. I was telling him about that I have applied to GNC, and I would love to work at either GNC or like Vitamin Shoppe, because for obvious reasons I need vitamins and stuff. So I was like, God, I would love to work there. He's like, what is your obsession with this place? And I'm like, because I shop at these places all the time, and I mean, if they would hire me, my paycheck would just go right back to them. So I think if they were to even give me an interview, I would tell them that. I'm like, I'll just be like, listen, if you give me this job, I mean, I shop here all the time. So, I mean, you guys are just gonna, it's just gonna benefit you, because my paycheck is gonna just go right back to you. So, I mean, if you guys wanna pay me in vitamins, I don't mind. So he just thought that was funny. But, yeah, I can't with him tonight, so. What else can I tell you about today? Today, I don't know, I'm hanging in there. Yeah, I'm gonna try to eat something today. I don't know what. Oh God, I don't know what. But I have to eat something. And I had a good workout yesterday. I'm gonna work out today again. I'm really sore, like my ribs hurt. I like to lay down on my stomach at night, and I was laying down there, and it was like really hard, and oh my God, I was like so aware of my rib cage, and I was really sore and stuff. I did some cardio last night, bouncing around. What can I tell you about today? I know I had something else to say, but I forgot. I don't know, I think that's it. I'm gonna cousins out with my kid now and start cooking and stuff. I hope you guys are all well. Enjoy your Saturday. As you can see, we're back up into production with the videos and nice high quality. I was scared. I'm like, wow, if I can't get batteries today, and I don't really want to use the desktop cam, then I think that I wouldn't be able to vlog anymore, and I would just have to do, like, I don't know, freaking radio broadcast, or like over the CB4 radio, like breaker breaker. This is So, the weather trend is good, as we can see. I'm very in good spirits. I think 150 milligrams is just what I needed. The doctor told me that, he's like, I'm going to put you on 150 milligrams when you're going to feel alert. And that's exactly his words, and I do. I feel like awake, alert. I'm up and stuff, so I'm going to try to stay positive today with the anxiety pill and with trying to eat something. And I think I'm going to do either Twilight Marathon today or a Pirates of the Caribbean Marathon. I feel like watching a bunch of consecutive nonsense in a row. So I'm going to say bye to you all and get this day started. And like I said, I hope you all are well. We'll talk again tomorrow. And that's it. So bye, everybody.